back, I uploaded a haul video where I showed you a lot of different makeup from Colourpop, Tarte, Nykaa. So I bought a lot of stuff. Now all of the products I can't be using in one video because then I will not be touching most of it. So I divided those products into two groups, and today I'm here with this look right here. What I did basically, the products which are easily available on Nykaa, I did my makeup with those products. So there was not a base product, so I did my foundation, my primer, all that off camera, and then I did my whole makeup in front of the camera. So you will be definitely seeing the try on during the process. I will be talking about the products, so let's get started and let's find out what all products really worked and what all didn't work for me at all. So to start up this video, we'll start with the eye products because I have only two eye products, out of which the first one is the L'Oreal Le Petite palette. Now if you know, if you have seen my last haul, you know how much excited I was about this Le Petite palette by L'Oreal. Now practically speaking, this is a total dud palette. I didn't like it because firstly, the shadows in here exactly are not like eyeshadows, and I don't know why they have made it so difficult. Secondly, the shimmers don't work the way they are supposed to. You just get one matte, which is this one. Okay, I don't even mind this kind of a matte, but uske saath complementing shades hai hi nahi. Secondly, the shimmers don't perform the way we are supposed to. If you see it in the pan, you feel it's a shimmer. When you pick it up with your hands, you feel it's not a shimmer, it's not a matte. So wo satin finish wale shadows hote hai na, this is somewhat like that. If you're a beginner, a starter, and you really don't know how to play with shadows, you are like just an amateur, like a baby step, you can get this palette, play with it, and then jump on to some good ones. But all in all, agar main makeup start karti aur main aisa palette use karti to main aankhon ka makeup karna chhod hi deti. So I would not suggest you to buy this one. This really didn't do anything. I didn't like my eye look today. Personally speaking, it didn't do anything great to my eyes. Instead, when I started blending, the shades started getting ashy. So usko fix karne ke liye maine ye wala shimmer leke bas puri aankhon pe laga liya. One shadow you can use it. Don't expect to blend and blend and blend and create some intense eye look. You are not going to get one. So if you are new to eye makeup and you really don't know what to do with the eye looks, you don't know how to use your brushes, you don't know how to blend and all, then this palette can be a handful palette. Why? You can use one shadow, do pure aankhon pe laga lo, kajal laga lo, liner laga lo, and you're done. That's how I would have used it if mujhe nahi aata makeup. All in all, for a person who knows eye makeup, who loves eyeshadows, you can just keep yourself away from this. This is not something to be, you know, where you should put in your money. Next product is a product which will work. It's just that I tried today, but I couldn't do it because I don't do this step regularly. So I need to get a good practice. This is the Pack Lash Fixer Eyelash Adhesive. It's good because I put on the lashes. It's the problem that I used my old lashes. So that is why I think uspe already bahut sara glue tha, and that is why it didn't stay for a longer duration. So I had to remove it. But I feel this lash fixture is good. The only thing is that you can't leave it for more than 5 to 10 seconds. 10 nahi, 15 bol lete hain. 15 seconds nahi to glue pura suk jata hai. To fir se aapko glue lagana padta hai, and then you have to fix your lashes. So the glue dries very fast, but I really like this one. I see myself wearing lashes, so I will be wearing, and I will let you see me in lashes fully glammed. Now these were the only two eye products. Now let's move on to some interesting face products because I have some. So moving on, I got two products from Faces Canada. Now one of it is a face powder. So the face powder I have used today, and I have been using it. It's a good powder. It's not a bad powder, but for an 899, I felt it is a little expensive. You can rather get some more inexpensive powders. The price point can be a little crunch to many. A lot of you would say that it is an expensive powder. So if you can get it in a good offer, then it's a good thing. But if I just talk about the quality of the powder, it's there. It's good. I have done my makeup almost 1.5 hours back. Aisa nahi hota, I do the makeup and I sit in front of the camera and start filming. I have a small kid. I have to look after him also. Now at this point, he's sleeping, so I'm filming. So mere makeup ko kafi time ho gaya hai, and I use the powder that time itself. and it is still put on. So the powder is doing the job. I really like the powder. It's very fine. It's not that, you know, thick powder which you can actually feel it on your face. It's not heavy. So yes, it is a good purchase. I'm glad that I got the powder instead of the highlighter. Next up, we have another interesting product by Faces Canada. The only reason of me getting this one was the shade. Now, I personally don't own... Okay, last haul video, I said I don't own a single face product by Faces Canada. And when I was watching that video, I realized that I have a bronzer by Faces Canada, which is my holy grail. So, sorry to say that. So, yeah, this is how the blush looks like. This is the shade... I don't know what shade it is. I think it's... The shade is not written, I feel, on the package. Yeah, it's Rosette 02. So again, this blush is amazing. Practically speaking, the camera is not doing justice to the blush. It's not even picking up the blush. The amount of blush I have on my face, you really don't know. Because today the light is a little off, so I had to switch on my ring light so that you can see my makeup completely. The blush is pigmented. The sheen which you see on the blush, don't mistake it with a shimmer or a highlighting blush. So it's not a highlighting blush, it's just gonna give you that very nice sheen. But the only negative factor which I see with this blush, if you have texture or if you are a little mature skin, then try avoiding this blush. Because mature skin se ye matlab nahi hota ki aap ki skin abhi bhi young dikh rahi hai, but you're old. It's just that ki sometimes not everybody have the, you know, the flawless skin in their oldies. So sabhi kabhi kya hota ki we tends to get big pores or open pores, or for that matter thoda blemishes hai ya thoda wrinkles hai ya thoda kuch has started happening on your face, and this kind of a blush can actually emphasize those things. Sometimes we don't see it with our bare eyes, but when we put our makeup, we tend to see everything very clearly. So if you have a textured skin, then I would say think about it and buy. But for now, I don't have a textured skin, so I'm still enjoying it. But a combination to oily can keep this blush away in summers, because it just gives us sheen, which people can mistake with your sebum secretion on your face. So that is something off about this blush. I would definitely enjoy this blush in winters, not in summers. But all in all, it's a good blush. Next up, we have another face palette by Makeup Revolution. This is a Makeup Revolution Patricia Bright face palette. Now, in my last haul video also, I mentioned that I absolutely love this palette. Now, this has three pretty little shades. Now, blush, I used Faces Canada, so I didn't use the blush today. But I used my bronzer and highlight from this palette. Bronzer is dead on. It's very pigmented, it's very good. I really like the consistency of the bronzer here. If you're of my skin tone, a little definitely lighter than me can enjoy this palette, but a deeper than me can also go in with this one. This is called as You Are Gold, and the bronzer is matte, so it really gives you that nice bronziness. With that, it also gives you that contour wala illusion. So if you're a person who loves to contour, can also use this shade as a contour shade. So it's a dual purpose. Secondly, the highlighter, I went in with the same highlighter. Now, don't mistake me, I'm a person who doesn't like too much of intense highlighter on my regular basis. If I'm doing my full-on glam makeup, I really go a little less with my highlighter, just because I feel that if I do too much, I look too much. With myself, I feel. So I like to go in with a very minimalist highlighter. So this highlighter is like a little minimalist, but it's pigmented. Sometimes the camera, due to lighting and all, the highlighter doesn't pick up that much. So first, kya hua tha? I used a wrong brush when I was applying my highlighter here, and then I realized the brush is a little stiffer for the highlighter. So I changed my brush to my normal regular highlighter brush, and then I got a very nice sheen here. So your brush has to be correct when you're applying your highlighter, or else you will feel the highlighter is chunky, glittery, or it doesn't show. So all in all, this is a 10 on 10 palette. If you're planning to invest your money here, you should definitely get this one, because it's good, it's pigmented, it works. Now we are down to the last product of this makeup try on. is the Colourbar Sinful Matte Lipstick. I have never spoken about these lipsticks in depth in any of my videos. Rather, I've shown these lipsticks. Now, I earlier bought two, and then later again, I bought one shade called XXX. Now, I absolutely love this shade. I watched Antariksha's video, and from that time, I knew that I need to get this one. Now, the best part about these lipstick, you really don't need a lip liner for these. I applied a lip liner by Nykaa. Because it's summers, it really helps the lipstick to hold for more longer duration and doesn't allow the lipstick to budge. All in all, the formula of this lipstick in particular is very good, very smooth, very buttery. But don't mistake that butteriness ki in summers it may start spilling here and there. No, it doesn't leak. It just stays on. The best part about these lipsticks are they are non-drying and they are matte and they're extremely matte. You eat anything, you drink anything, the lipstick is gonna be there. But if you happen to eat a burger, then the lipstick is gonna go. Because I have had burger after wearing this lipstick, not this one, the shade Sin, and the lipstick went away, but not completely. There's a last tint will be there, but the lipstick would not go completely. So all in all, the formula is really up-notch. This is a very different kind of a lipstick by Colourbar, and for that matter, in any brand, I have not seen a formula like this. Yes, wait for the comparison video, which is coming soon. You will definitely find one. But this one definitely is a 10 and 10 lipstick. I'm happy that I got three shades, and I'm eyeing 2-3 shades more. So yes, thank you to my subscribers who suggested me and forced me to buy this one. This is fully approved. Get it. So guys, I hope you loved watching this interesting small mini review on these interesting new products. I hope you got some help. Link to all the products will be mentioned in my description, and we'll be back soon with something more exciting on my channel. Don't forget to subscribe before you leave. Follow me on my Instagram @bronzinggeek. Till then, you take care and see you soon.